gotta do something to make yourself stand out, or you might get lost, right?
Well, you do. I mean, if you want to find a role, you know, you gotta do something to stand out. Like, can't have a bunch of cookie cutters at linebacker. You gotta have some diversity in what people can do. And I think that I can play the same role. I think that I can rush off the edge or whatever it may be, you know, yeah. Whatever this Sam thing leads to. We only got just a couple calls right now. So.
Do you feel that dirty kind of, you know, that Sam linebacker is your calling? Was that what you thought you would play when you got here? Or was that kind of, or what was that process like?
No, and when I got here, you know, we didn't really have a Sam linebacker when I got here because it was Coach Wash, Coach Combs. And it was a 4-2-5 structure. And in the spring last year, we didn't hardly run any or have to go against any 12 personnel. And another thing is, last spring there was only 4 or 5 linebackers by the end of spring ball. So, but no, I figured that I would always probably be a Mike Will guy just because Sams are typically, you know, 6'3", 6'4 guys.
So what mental adjustments do you have to make to kind of get ready for that position that you may have not thought yourself being it?
Well, I'd just say that, you know, it's, you got to be physical every single play. You got guys you're just 2 or 3 yards from, and they're coming to run through your face, and you got to go run through theirs. I mean, that's pretty much the reality of the position.
Are you doing any Mike cross training at this point?
Yeah, I'm a little too. I've gotten more reps a little through spring.
Talk about being a cookie cutter.
Last question,
right? Not being a cookie cutter, but also, like, you almost have to be a little bit of standard, like, cookie cutter in the sense of, like, you have to be at the exact same level at the exact same time. How do you kind of balance that? Making sure that you're sticking out, but also making sure that you're not trying too hard to stick out and be different, or you might get, caught in the wash and all the way.
Well, I can kind of clear that statement up. You want to be a cookie cutter. As far as the culture goes, you know, you got to give great effort. You got to be a good tackler. You got to put the silver bullets first. And then, personally, you know, when it comes to finding a niche or a role, you got to have something that sets you apart. So, you know, like Tommy Eichenberg. Tommy Eichenberg knows the game just about fine. He makes mistakes, but he's very sharp. You know, Steele comes up big in third down packages, you know, makes plays. Like last year, played a couple screens perfectly on third down, you know, things like that. And it's just, you got to have something that the DC or your position coach or whoever sees in you that you can do well, and they'll find a place for it.
What feels like as a linebacker coach?
In the meeting room, pretty chill. Cover a lot of material in a short amount of time, really. And, you know, when we get out here on the field, you know, he's a fiery guy, just as you would expect.
You use the term silver bullets.
Last question right here.
You use the term silver bullets there. I haven't heard that this spring, just because I think everybody's so locked in on just trying to get back to where the defense needs to be. Mm-hmm. How much pride do you take in those two words, just being the silver bullets and getting the defense back to the silver bullets?
Well, it's held in high regard. I mean, every single unit meeting that we have, Coach Knowles puts up on the board 5 things that, you know, make a silver bullet and what you have to live up to every single day. And, you know, we take tremendous pride in that. And it's been like that for years now. And it's not going to change.
Thank you, Reid.